source code is, and we'll also show you how to view a web page source. What is a source code? Source code basically refers to all the components used in building a website or creating a computer program. This includes things like text, images, scripts, style sheets, media files, and so on. This is a basic web page or HTML document I created in previous videos. A web page is also referred to as an HTML document. So this is the piece of code, the HTML code that has created this basic web page. And if you look on the page, we've also got images. We've got an image. And this image here obviously is part of this web page. So if someone sees this page and they ask me, can I have the source code for this web page? So what I'll need to do basically is give them the project folder, which is this folder here. This here is what I would have to send to them or make this folder available for download, or I can compress it using a software compression tool like WinZip, WinRAR, or 7-Zip, make it compressible so that it is easier to send via email, or we can make that available as a download. So this will be what I will send to whoever's made a request for the source code for the web page. So if I open up this folder here, it contains everything that was used to build the web page. We can see this is the index here, which is this page here. And then we've got inside the images folder, we've got the image I used, which is this, which is the image of this poppy. And we've got the other folders, although there's nothing in this script folder and there's nothing in the style sheet at the moment, but this is basically what is known as the source code, all the components you use in building your website or creating a computer program. Next, I'm going to show you how you can view the source for a web page. So I'll start with this page here. So to view the source, all you need to do is right click anywhere inside the page that is opened, and there's an option here that says view page source. So if you click on it, it opens up. As you can see here, we can see the HTML we've used to construct this page, which is this HTML here. So that's basically how to view the source for a web page. Obviously, this is a very simple page, but if you want to view the source for a more complicated website like Facebook or Google, there will be a lot more in here, and some of it you may not be able to read because it will contain other stuff apart from HTML as well. So this is the Google homepage. So if I wanted to view the page source for here, I just right click and click on view page source. You can see when it launches that there's a lot of stuff in here, but you can see just about make out the HTML, the doc type, which is there. And then you can see other stuff as well, because there may be things like advertisement and other things related. You can see this is more complicated than a very simple web page we've seen. So basically, if you want to view the some of the code behind a website, you just go to the page source and you can see it. A lot depends if on the programming language used. There are some programming languages that the actual source code is not displayed when you go to view page source. the actual code is processed by the backend server, and then the server returns the processed after converting it into a way the web browser can read. It then sends that back to the web browser. So sometimes you may not always be able to read what's in the page source. This is a simple website called example.com. So www.example.com. You can see it's a very basic website. If I wanted to view the page source to see how this page was constructed, I just right click and go to view page source, and you can see the page source. It tells you, you can see the HTML used to build the page. This is some CSS here as well. And here we've got some media files. So basically it shows you how the page was constructed. In this video, I will explain what attributes are, and will also show you an example of an HTML attribute being used. What are HTML attributes? Attributes basically are used to provide additional information about an element. So they contain extra information about the element that you do not want to appear in the actual content. All HTML elements can have attributes. There are some properties that all attributes should have. They should have a space between it and the element name. The equals to sign is used to assign a value to a attribute. The value of the attributes are enclosed in quotes. Attributes are always specified in the opening element tag. Attributes are paired. That means they will have a name and they will also have a value. I have used an attribute in one of the previous videos in this course. I use a source attribute. I'm going to go over that attribute again. There are different types of attributes, and the source attribute is one of such attributes. It's usually used inside an image tag. So when you are using the HTML image tag to define an image, you use the source attribute, which I have used here on line 11 of my code editor. You can see the source attribute and is spelled src. So this is the name of the attribute, and you can see the equals to sign here. The equals to is used to give the attribute a value, and you have to enclose the value in quotes. You can see here I've enclosed the value of this attribute, which is called source. I've enclosed it in quotes. The source attribute, when used with an image tag, basically is used to reference the file name where the image is located. In my example, my image is located inside my images folder, which is this image, and inside, and this is the name of the image. So I'm referencing the location of the image using the source attribute. I also want to introduce you to another attribute that we've also used before. The attribute is called the alt attribute, also referred to as alternative attribute. This attribute basically is used to specify an alternative text to be used when an image cannot be displayed. In my code editor here inside the image tag, I've also got this alt attribute here. So if for any reason this image cannot be displayed, the alternative text I have specified here will be displayed instead. Say for example, I know that the name of this image is called poppy.jpg. If I come here and just add a 1 to it, you can see the image no longer shows. It's now showing the alternative text instead, which says poppy image. So that's one of the ways or benefits of using the alt attribute with an image tag. So I've corrected that now. You can see the image is now showing correctly. Another valuable reason for using the attribute, the alt attribute, is that the value of the attribute can be read by screen readers. This way, someone listening to the web page, for example, a blind person, can hear the element. So the descriptive text helps users who have visual impairment and cannot actually see the image, so they're able to interpret or read the text instead. And they're able to do that using special software called screen readers, which enable them to read the text that is on the screen for the visually impaired. So that's it for this brief introduction to HTML attributes. I've only introduced you to a couple of attributes in this video, but there are tons of HTML attributes out there. Thank you for watching, and bye for now.